room, see you now. You see him from the light, hypnotized by.
So I'm here with Bloom Allen. Hi, Bloom. How are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm good. I'm Danny, and I'm just going to ask you a few questions, try to get to know you better. Sound good?
Yeah. All right, sounds great.
So, first question, how did you first connect with music? Like, how would you describe your connection with it, kind of music you listened to growing up?
Man, it's a tough one. I mean, music was definitely always in the house. Like, none of my parents are necessarily musicians, but
okay.
It was always, I mean, my dad, like, I think probably by now my dad's probably accumulated around like 1,000 vinyls, and he's got like a multi-thousand dollar setup. Like, he's a nerd, especially about blues and jazz. And then my mom was the one that introduced me to like pop, and then just growing up in like just a bunch of different places, just like, I don't know, figuring out hip hop too. Like, I remember when I was like 10, the first time I heard MF Doom, I think like my brain fell out of my body, like, or like just like stuff like that. Like,
Doom is crazy.
I grew up in obviously independent, so a huge one too is like Tech Nine. Hold on, muscle. You don't want to be in a tussle. Better than me, that's rubble. You want trouble? What's up, though? Yo, he's like the biggest local thing ever here. So that was a crazy one too. And then I think like pop music was a big one too, like Jack Johnson. Yeah, so much better when we're together. Yeah, so much better when we're together. Was kind of my first introduction to like acoustic stuff, and that was my mom too, and that was like mind blowing as well.
Got it. So like, would you say that, I guess, your parents' taste of music helped you develop the ability to blend certain elements? Because I know you should come around. Come around. You won't come around anymore. Save me now. You should come around. It's like super folky, acoustic guitar, just you and the guitar, and then it switches into the lo-fi, like hip-hop, backpack kind of rap. Do you think that those elements, you know, of your parents and the different genres that they listened to helped you blend?
For sure. I think it's always fun to, like, blend a bunch of genres. Like you said, it was, like, hip-hop, you know, that's, like, kind of how I started making music, was, like, my friends all rapped and stuff, like, and then, so I just kind of picked up from them, like, how to do hip-hop, and then the acoustic stuff was just me, like, struggling for years to try and learn to play guitar, and then, you know, like, finally sort of figuring out, like, I don't know anything about guitar still, but, you know, enough to get by, I guess.
Definitely.
And the folkiness, definitely, like, that would probably be, like, my dad, too, well, that was definitely parents and definitely friends, too. I have a lot of, like, good friends still, like, you know, since I've been, you know, have friends for years that have shown me like folk stuff, and and R&B as well. R&B was like a huge turner, especially like late 90s, like Silk, D'Angelo, like those dudes, like those
yeah
dudes
D'Angelo is great. You're the most precious thing, baby. I got the dreaming eyes I've ever seen.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan. Have all his vinyls, like even the third one, the most recent one with I forget what the band is, but or the orchestra, I think. I can't remember, but yeah. Huge D'Angelo nerd.
Yeah, definitely crazy. Well, speaking of You Should Come Around, your director had great things to say about you.
Yeah. I'm dating her, so I hope so.
Oh, there it is. There's the scoop.
Yeah, that's the girlfriend. So, yeah, very talented videographer. Her and Graycie, very talented people.
Yeah, that video is great. That video is great because it's simple in a way that ties everything together. It's just you and the guitar, which is what it needs to be. I think that you guys did a great job with that. What was it like for you, you know, working with them?
Oh, I mean, it was great. Like, I've always known Riley's a good videographer, and Gracie's her best friend too. So it was just kind of like, I was like, I want to do a music video. Like, I wanted kind of the debut single to be like a good full rollout thing. But I'm terrible at like video, just in general. Like, it makes me really anxious. Like. And so I think, and definitely a rollout for like the newer stuff too. It's all like, I'm just handing it off to like someone far more talented than I am, for sure.
Yep.
But it was a blast. We went to Unionville, Missouri, which is a good, I think, 1,000 people on like a popular Saturday. We drove around, and that's where they're both from. And yeah, it was fun. We hopped in the back of Riley's grandpa's truck and drove around, and then found this great, like, we just found this field with that, like, with that big giant tree.
Yep.
We're just like, all right, this is a spot. We did it all in a day too, which was insane. We shot the whole thing in one day, so it was crazy.
Well, it worked out well, so.
Yeah, thank goodness. It could have been so much worse, so.
Well, it sounds like you were in good hands, so it all works out.
They're very, very talented. If anyone's looking for music in Kansas City.
Oh, okay. If you met a fan and they misinterpreted like what a song meant, or, you know, what the general feel was for it, would you be happy that they're happy about the way the song feels for them? Or would you, like, do you often find yourself wanting your narrative to be told, or do you let the fans just, you know, interpret the music the way that they want?
Oh yeah, I mean, the listener is, you know, I put whatever I feel into it, but
I
mean, a song means something for everybody. Like,
yep,
man, I just had this conversation with my friend Tanner Agpoon. He's just coming out with some new stuff soon. He's fantastic.
Sick.
But we just had this conversation about like how like people got his first two singles like totally wrong on the subject, and he was so excited about it, and like I was the same way, where I was like, yeah, man, it means whatever, you know. Like, I think, oh, and we talked about like Frank Ocean and Tyler, the Creator's like most recent ones, and we just had completely different ideas of like what it was about and like relating it to like our own stuff, and it was like,
yeah,
that's great. I fucking love that when two, like, if I think my song sounds a certain way or feels a certain way, and someone's like, I feel completely different, I'm like, fucking awesome. That means I'm doing something right, I feel like. If they're getting multiple things from it, I feel like that's kind of the goal. So, no, I'd never correct anybody. I'd be like, yep, that's, yeah, you feel whatever you feel.
Yeah, you're definitely doing something right. Because it's always interesting when someone else comes up with the whole, you know, another scenario about your music, and then you're just kind of like,
I didn't even
think about that. That's actually a good point, you know?
Someone DM'd me, they thought it was, like, this whole story. You should come around. They thought it was, like, this whole story, and I was like, no, but fuck yeah. Like, sure, yeah. It made me just be like, wow, I feel like I should just simplify it even more so people can just throw whatever they feel into the...
throw into anything at the wall.
Yeah, just see if it sticks.
Couple more questions for you.
Yeah.
If you got a chance to chat with one musician, who would it be?
Dijon. Wait, alive or dead?
Doesn't matter.
Okay, I would talk to... If they passed away, I would talk to either Prince... or Hendrix. And then alive, I Dijon, dude. You put on this fair, and you lean back in your chair, and you turn it down. I got 50 miles. Dijon is like my fucking hero. Like, he's so fucking talented. He's so good.
What would you ask him?
Oh my god.
You got two questions to ask. What would they be if you were put in that scenario?
I would ask how he starts a song.
Okay.
Like, what is the very first thing? And I would ask Oh, I would ask if there's one song he's always wanted to write that he has never figured out how to write yet. Like, if there's one type of song that he has never figured out yet.
Do you have a song that's
I like have that? Like a million songs that I can't figure out. Yeah, for sure. But I feel like that, whatever that answer would be, because I feel like there's always a song people are trying to write that like seven songs come out of anyway that weren't quite there. But like, if he gave me that answer, that's like, oh, that's how you came up with like the entire Absolutely album. Like, that's how you came out with, you know, like these singles and like, that's how you, because I feel like it's that, what's that saying? Like, aim for the moon and then the, like, miss at the stars or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Like, that's, like, whatever the moon is, like, a huge answer, I feel like, for musicians.
Definitely.
Or just artists in general, like, you know, or a piece that you, like, could never paint yet. Like, that's...
Exactly.
That would be a great answer. That would be something I would want to know.
Yeah. Definitely, because I feel like all artists, like you said, everyone has something that they really want to create. And I think that...
Yeah.
In a lot of situations, whatever it is that you really want to create in your journey to trying to create that, you end up creating something completely different, but you're still happy with, and it usually works out for you.
Usually a lot of it too. Like, I feel like that one song can produce like whole projects.
Yep.
You know, that you can figure out how to write.
Yeah. Sometimes an idea isn't a song. It's the concept. Or, you know, maybe, you know, it's the feel, or maybe it's an inspiration. It could be a lot of things.
Yeah, and that would probably blow my mind, like, how he would answer it, too. Like, would he say a subject? Would he say, like, a vibe he's never, like, hit before?
Yep.
Or would he just say, like, a key that he's, like, never been able to sing in or something like that? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That guy's a psycho. I could not imagine what he would say. That would be a great, that's what I would ask.
That would be a great one. All right, well, it's been great talking to you, Bloom.
Thank you, man. It's been great talking to you guys. Thank you so much for supporting my stuff. Like, that's great.
Of course. You're good. Oh, wait. You know what? I have one more thing to ask you, if that's okay. How did your collaboration with Popstar Paris, how did that come about? How did that go? What was that experience like? Show me.
Yeah, so I released You Should Come Around under French Exit Records.
Okay.
And we released that song too. So Brad Gerard is the guy that kind of runs that thing. We're hanging at his house and he was like, we just kind of like playing this thing where it was like, I was really making like a lot of hip hop beats. Just, you know, I was trying to get out of my own, maybe, I don't know, genre is stupid, but.
Yeah.
He's like, well, Popstar's, you know, Paris is coming by. And I was like, yeah, this is going to be cool. And it was literally just one night. We came in, I was like already working on this beat. Paris came by, it was like, this is hard. And then we were kind of sitting there and we didn't have a hook. And I was really like not in the zone to like sing or anything.
Record. Yeah.
I always have this like terrible confidence in like a studio setting. Like, I've been in a lot of sessions and stuff. I just like lose all my like, I just
especially
don't, I
if
don't
you're
have
singing something
like, yeah,
like especially if you're singing something, you're so self-conscious, you know.
And that's a high song for me too. Like, that's a high,
yeah,
it's really on top, like at the top of my range. And I remember the most embarrassing one was the very first take. After we had kind of done everything, we had added guitars, like the beat sounded great. Paris already sounded like pre-mixed, pre-mastered, fantastic, just because he has a great voice. I'ma work for mine, treat the rap like Roflex. Heavy on the grind,
I've been playing in reps. Tell the baby hit my line, I'm just trying to see you sweat. Yeah.
And crazy bars too. And then I remember my very first take, I voice cracked so bad. That was like, it was like I jumped like three octaves in like one thing.
Oh my God.
And like that. And they were like, but it was great because it like, I think it was a little like shy. Everyone was still shy getting to know each other.
Yeah.
Like, I knew Brad and Paris knew Brad. But right after that, it was just like homies. Cause it was like, this is, we're fucking around. Like, this is fun. This, we don't have to take ourselves as seriously.
Yeah,
and it was,
definitely.
It was such a blast making that song. And it's like blown up recently too. It's been it's been like a really good, lots of local people really like it. Paris is enjoying playing it live, I think, in some shows. He's got a ton of shows coming up.
Oh,
and
sick.
Yeah, that was such a just like fun. You know, it's a good song. Like you can listen to it 1,000 times and you still made it in like one day. Like I feel like that's such good. It was just such a good energy and stuff.
Yeah, especially when, because sometimes you have songs that you make that are like, okay, this is a cool song, but you don't really listen to it that often. I think when you find yourself listening. Yeah, exactly. When you find yourself listening to yourself.
If I were rapping, I could never listen to that song ever. I cannot rap. So maybe it's just Paris.
What?
Bars.
What? I don't know. I don't know if I believe that.
I have absolutely the worst bars. I cannot spit.
Nah, man. What you did on You Should Come Around was great. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you, man. That's, don't sell that's yourself not rapping, short. So I don't think
well,
you won't hear Blue Mallory 16 anytime soon. But
okay, okay. Yeah, I understand what you're saying. Well, it's been great talking to you. I'm
hey, man,
so glad I got to get to know you. Your music is great.
Thank you. New stuff very soon.
Definitely. Any projects you're working on that's coming out soon? Should we expect anything?
Yeah, so I have an EP under some new people, some new very exciting people. And it will be mixed, hopefully, by the homie Pierce of the Greeting Committee, who I've been able to like become really, really good friends with. And he's been helping me kind of produce and direct the EP a little bit.
Got it.
I got some homies on that playing drums too. It's going to be a really good project. It'll be really fun. And the visuals, I have a bunch of fun people doing the visuals. I got Riley and Graycie, obviously. And then I also have some other homies from the Kansas City Artists too. They're going to be helping me with the visuals too. So it's going to be very good. It'll be a very wild, non-stagnant EP. It's going to be all over the place.
That
so,
sounds good.
Yeah. It'll be fun.
Keep people interested.
Yeah, it's gonna be like it's gonna be like my ADD brain in music form. It's gonna be all over the place.
That's the best way to put it.
Yeah.
All right, man. Thank you so much for sitting with me and talking with me.
Of course, man. Thank you for having me on. This has been
fun. Of course. Of course. All right, man. Until next time.
Yeah, man. Peace. You look so fine. We should get a few drinks, maybe young wine. Hey, sunshine, you look sublime. And in due time, I'll make you all mine. So, show me your sunlight now. Glow, grow as your blue skies.